England clock in for their very first appearance in these championships. A special anniversary edition, in fact, games held across multiple nations. A true pan-European tournament that is a reflection of the pan-European nature of the game. And this is where it all starts for them. 11 players, many of them friends, some foes during the league season, now united for a single cause as they carry the hopes and expectations of a nation in this grand quadrennial event. Ahead of us, a month of non-stop adrenaline rush. I trust you are strapped in comfortably for what will be at least four partisan parties, the most unbearable, thrilling of emotional roller coasters. Stadio Olimpico, a venue that has an old school feel about it. Well, they have thrown down the gauntlet with that anthem. Now to match it. So it is upon us, their opening game, and what they hope will be the first of many fine games in this championship.
All I hope is that these nations, as well as the players, of course, can make a good account of themselves. And I also like the fact that such excitement isn't just something that one host country has the monopoly of. It's shared by so many people across the continent, literally, and that certainly created an extra special buzz.
The whistle, and here we go. Jim, who do you reckon is pivotal?
Yeah, Harry Kane. He's a deadly finisher, Peter, obviously, but he can contribute much more than that for his team. He's got the physical presence to hold the ball up and the awareness to bring pretty much everyone else into play. His best attributes, however, might be his enthusiasm, his energy, and his desire to win, because those things become infectious to others.
Yes, he's certainly the one who carries the hopes of his team. That'll be a throw. Point-blank header! Decent attempt, but not quite good enough. Madison. Trippier. Muller shoots, and for a moment time stood still.
A chance that's created through very good grafting. Did well to get in the face of his opponent.
The ball needed to be better there, it's a wasted chance. Shaw delivers, looking for goal! Goretzka plays it forward. Madison gets it into the middle. A retrieve, albeit perhaps momentary. And this could be a German counter. Throw in. Played in by Sané. Trying to get there. Sané. Henderson demonstrating fabulous determination. He just will not be beaten. Foden. It's Rashford. It's found its way to him. Corner then. Great! knocked away. Aimed in towards the centre. The chances keep on coming. They're awarded another corner. Germany happy to let their strikers roam out wide.
I wouldn't want that.
No?
Well, my worry is that their main threat is being shifted out of contention.
It's a long ball, but it's not hit its target. Götze gets it out to the wing, and it's got through. Played into space out wide. To get that all wrong. Madison. Trippier tries to get it forward quickly. Doesn't get the pass he's looking for. Dyer goes looking. Schüller spreads it towards the left. Trippier hit into them, gets up to head it! Oh, just needed a better contact.
He simply mistimed the header, and it was as if he knew it wasn't going to work out.
Very well to intervene,
and it's Kane.
A buccaneering run from the defender. Real chance! Turns and goes back. He's gone for goal! That's a half-decent try.
Very speculative, with little threat, if any, for the keeper.
Kimmich. Müller. Here it comes. Has it out wide now. Pressure stays on, it is a corner.
Sporting here to acknowledge the quality of the save. A lovely little footballing moment.
That is going to be the final action of the first half. And both sides have drawn blanks. It's cold at times, but it's not been a bad game by any means. So we reach the halfway point.
What a pleasant surprise to see how open this game is turning into. Just wondering if the two teams are going to keep doing what we've seen in the first half. I hope that a cautious aspect doesn't kick in.
So they head in no further forward. The score here, still 0-0. We're probably into the second 45 minutes. No score in the first half. Who's ready to go for it now? And it's Götze.
Kimmich. Goretzka.
Lovely bit of skill there. Götze! So now we're going to get those changes we have been expecting. Up to meet it! No, he didn't quite meet it right. Madison. Trippier, in by Trippier.
It's always going to be the keepers.
Sané.
Schüller. Forward it goes. Shaw. Shaw tries running with the ball at his feet. Kane. It's Kane!
A good finish. The odds go against him. Little matter.
Oh, this fella's as sneaky as a mule when he freed himself to score. I mean, for that defence, it was a case of when you've got him, when you don't, will you?
Germany making consecutive changes here. A 1-0 lead established.
Surprise, surprise. He just keeps on delivering. And listen, we all expect that.
Brandt takes it out to the wing. Brandt. Gundogan drives it forward. Kane pushes to get on the end of it. Cuts it out. Brandt. Jordan Henderson.
They've got it back as soon as they gave it away. Great build-up. It all deserved a better ending.
Well, there are a few pockets of space that are being exploited, and they need filling, and fast.
Played it short. Gundogan moves to the cross.
That's not going to find its target.
Foden, with good energy in defence as well.
Well, they say that your front lads should be that first line of stopping the opposition, and I think he's taken it to another level with his desire to get back and help everyone out.
And they've been caught out here. Germany showing a little more urgency now, and to be honest, Peter, this is what's required. Well, this isn't the time to talk about risks now, Jim, is it? They just have to hurl everything at it and hope for a break.
Spot on, Peter.
Massive leap! Oh, nearly. But nearly is nothing.
Good effort. Very good effort. He would have at least wanted to make the keeper work, though.
Rudiger. On the right now, what's on? He gets past his man.
Germany are actually displaying tremendous fighting spirit. There's a real belief that they can still have a say.
And it's Trippier. He's played him through.
England are looking to make this one safe. They want to reduce the risk.
Sané.
Over to the left. Sané. Gundogan looks to set one up. And it's been taken short. Played into the middle. Towering header! Should have equalised.
I think he rushed that. He had a bit more time than he realised. He could so easily have equalised there.
Hoists it forward. almost there, and the players can feel it.
Hoists it high.
They need a goal, however it comes. And it's played forward.
Well, it remains to be seen whether they can come up with that little bit of class to rescue the situation. It needs to be any time now, really.
Played in by Sané, and that's been well dealt with. Muller with a shot! Oh, he couldn't get hold of it. And there goes the final whistle. And that's the way to launch the campaign. They can look ahead with confidence and comfort. We look back on the game then, Jim.
Well, they've laid down a marker with such a good opening win, and they're saying to the rest of the group, we'll intend on staying at the top.
England have just one thing on their minds, and that is to ensure that that coveted place in the knockout stages is theirs after 90 minutes. They have the luxury of knowing it is in their own hands. 3 points would be plenty to see them through. However, anything less than that, and it could become precarious. Look on the faces of the players, nothing but utterly focused. They know what they have to do. A big performance now will count. This must be amongst the favourite arenas of supporters all over the world. It really does have a very special feel to it. And we rise now for the English national anthem. That was impressive. Match that. It's a terrific sight here, and it goes to underline just how far this game could go towards shaping the fortunes of the team.
Well, if they can't find the motivation required for this, they might as well pack it in, Peter. This is the type of defining game that can propel the status of the whole club into the kind of territory where it needs to take its game. While individual careers may be helped with good performances, this has to be about the collective. If that remains strong, everything else should fall nicely into place.
So it's down to business here.
Jim, you've played in games of this nature. Who can make the difference?
I would say one of the most energetic midfielders you'll find in Jordan Henderson. He's added to all that running power with slicker passing and some very impressive finishing. And he's a proper leader now, too.
Yes, getting the best out of him will count for so much. Mbolo could try cutting inside here. Cross deflected behind for a corner. Stones knocks it away. Rodriguez gets flagged offside. Granit Xhaka, and it's played forward. Stones plays it forward. For a moment you felt that was going somewhere, but they'll have to go again. Gets wrestled off the ball. Maddison tries a pass forward.
Well, they would seem to be trying to expose the centre of that defence to runners.
Makes for some terrific movement.
It does, and they may be hit on the break because obviously it requires numbers forward to stretch them out.
Rodriguez. And here's Mbolo. Has a hit! Finish in the end. What do you think, Jim?
It's a simple game. The striker's job is to find the space as often as possible, and he did exactly that.
Switzerland take the lead, 1-0.
And that ought to be the trigger for a really exciting and entertaining game from here on.
Trippier played into going for goal!
He reacted well.
Oh, that was a cracking ball in because it just took the goalkeeper out of the equation.
Xhaka tries to get it forward quickly. And here's Mbolo. Yeah, he's pulled him up for that challenge. He's got options out wide. Shoots! Xhaka gets rid without sophistication. Now it's Seferovic. Sure. Victory now would mean so much. And it's Seferovic. Bolo. Seferovic.
For me, that's just pure predatory brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation when nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
Switzerland get themselves a two-goal cushion.
Well, at 1-0, this contest was still nicely poised, but now that it's gone to two, mindsets are affected a lot more. Winning belief one way and that losing feeling the other.
Henderson. Distance on it. Jordan Henderson. Madison. Sterling. Is there any support? He might not need it. England in need of a lift as we head up towards the break. He's left his man.
Granit Xhaka.
Hoists it forward. Switzerland have it back and they can go again. And it's Mbolo. And here's Kane. And here's Sterling. Trippier.
It's half-time here.
Views on the first half?
Yeah, it's looking pretty straightforward, because they've got themselves into a very good position, so why ditto from here when they can repeat their first half success with another show of strength?
Just 45 minutes from now, we will know who goes through from this group.
Look, before they might get too carried away with thoughts of getting back into the game, they can't afford to slip up and concede another. The next goal becomes crucial.
Now it's Seferovic. Good steal, he just read it.
A really good feat.
In he flies! And shoots! And it's there! And the lead is extending still further. It's no fluke, it's what he was there for.
Look, there's only one player who merits all the praise for that. Not only did he finish it, but his instincts for being where he was are absolutely top-notch.
He snaffles his third, and that earns him the match ball.
Well, he's been the outstanding player on the pitch and devastating in front of the goal. What a display, what a player.
Three without reply. This is becoming a stroll. Into a dangerous position. Kane with a good steal, well played. Rashford. Madison. He's looked long this time. Now tries a shot! Oh, just lacked a decent finish.
Well, the control on receipt was far better than the control on dispatch.
Xhaka goes looking. Foden. And here's Kane. Rodriguez placed it clear. Forward it goes. More than happy to take the muscular approach.
Mbolo really got caught in a trap there, and he just couldn't get out.
Foden not easily shrugged off the ball.
Yeah, that's top defending and preventing him turning, which can open up many possibilities.
We sit high. Nice ditch defending, but that'll do. Tries to get it forward quickly. Oh, what a ball! Kane! It's there! And you've got to say, the odds on him missing from there were very slim.
Well, considering he has a bit of a shoot-on-sight policy, he was the one player that should have been picked up then. It was both careless and costly from where I'm sitting.
So, is this the start of a comeback?
Dyer
positions himself well and cuts it out.
And it's Kane.
Trippier goes for goal! Oh, fine stop from the keeper.
The keeper really dug out his defence then. A magnificent effort.
And here's Seferovic. Finds himself eased off the ball. And it's Mbolo. Seferovic.
Ball's loose. Who's getting there? Well, that's where he wants it. Here it comes. Rashford gets the better of his man. And he's there to clear it. Oh, that is asking for trouble. Trippier in again. Massive leap!
And he heaves it forward.
Shaw back in once more. Great leap! Oh, he's managed to miss it.
And he could have eased the pressure on his team by taking them within one of an equaliser.
Tries to get it clear. It's a throw in. Yeah, that does look a foul. Referee's given a free kick.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Good challenge, he just stood firm. Fired in from distance. And he's there to hoof it away. Hoisted towards, gets up to hit it! Great early ball. Can't be set for the finish.
Well, if only the calibre of the finish was as high as the calibre of the supplier. I mean, it was a beautifully played cross and really should have seen something better on the end of it.
And it's Mbolo. Ricardo Rodriguez. Hoists it forward. Seferovic.
The referee brings it to a close. The players certainly gave it everything, but just didn't get the break. Terrific support, terrific effort, but the wrong outcome. How would you sum up what we've witnessed, Jim?
England seem to have taken this on with a complacent mentality to just turn up and win, and they deserve the criticism they're going to get.
England.
Emerging for this crucial group game here, the tournament still in its relative infancy.
It is already developing into quite a spectacle, and that, of course, is what you expect from this, the greatest of all the tournaments. It has been terrific stuff so far, so let us hope the trend continues here and there. This is the gladiatorial arena that is the Stadio Olimpico, for so long the symbol of Rome's grand sporting history. We have already started here. Jim, which player is best equipped for this game?
Yeah, Jordan Pickford. He's a great all-round goalkeeper, Peter. Great at shot-stopping and dominant in his box. He also gets counter-attacks going with his accurate long passes. The opposition should be a little wary of committing too many men forward to attack, because if it does break down, this guy can get them in trouble pretty quickly.
OK, interesting. He's on his way. Can't get the better of his opposite number. Regardless of the outcome, it is good to see someone running at the defence line.
Oh, that is asking for trouble. Gets the better of his man. Goes for goal! Goes to finish! They score!
It's hardly a surprise, is it? That's what we're here for, a player with this wonderful knack of being able to show up and deliver at important times. Yet another example.
Foden did well there. He was onto it in a trice.
Well, for me, that's just pure predatory brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation when nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
England have made their breakthrough, so can they build on it? Good challenge. He just stood firm. Whistle's gone. That's a foul. Well, the referee has made it pretty clear now that this is his last chance.
Yeah, and he has to change his ways or this...
Shoots! Oh, denied brilliantly!
Oh, that's a sparkling save. Absolutely sparkling. His reflexes were ultra-sharp.
England are enjoying a good spell right now and leading. Maddison. Just deflected behind for a corner. Last ditch defending, but that'll do. Maddison. Sir Harvey. Looking to break out here. Just brushed off the ball there. Tries to get it forward quickly. That's great strength on the ball. Great strength, too strong for his opponent. Now a chance to break. That looks a foul. Yep, referee's given it. Maddison. Alexander Arnold crosses one in. Massive lead! Well picked out, just needed a better finish.
Well, if only the calibre of the finish was as high as the calibre of the supply. I mean, it was a beautifully played cross and really should have seen something better on the end of it.
And here's Sir Harvey, shapes to shoot! Well, he should have done better, and he knows it.
Sir Harvey did give it a fair old crack, and he'll be encouraged to step up again.
England scored early, of course, and the score is 1-0. Shaw gets into the right position to intercept. Hoists it forward.
Oh, good interception.
Gets it back. Jordan Henderson. And here's Sir Harvey. And it's Natko. That intervention was very necessary.
A reprieve, albeit perhaps momentary.
He is not one readily to admit defeat. Don't be surprised if he tries that again. Rashford, he's got away. Chance!
Oh, so close to what would have been a memorable goal.
Rashford just might have got a little ahead of himself then. Maybe he had too much thinking time.
And it's played forward. Rashford is onto it and can take it out.
How many interceptions have we seen now? Someone's got to up the quality and set an example.
That is terrific skill. Up to meet it!
Oh, he couldn't get the direction he needed.
Well, plenty of moving targets to pick out in the box. Obviously increases the chances of the ball being met like that by someone.
Forward it goes. Hit into the middle. He just whacks it away. And he's there to clear it. Looks to clip it forward. We hit half-time. So there you have it. Post-sport half of football. Still had its moments. And ultimately produced just one goal.
Well, that certainly pleased the fans, and the players are definitely happy with that scoreline. The question is now, can they protect it?
England, happier of the teams, heading in for half-time, 1-0 up. We're promptly into the second 45 minutes.
A solitary goal, that has been the crucial difference.
Hoists it forward. Looks to bypass the midfield. Done very well to intervene. And here's Kane. Caught offside that time. Jordan Henderson. Henderson plays it forward. Kyle. Dyer. Shaw.
England making a fresh attempt to release someone in behind from back to front. And this is something different.
Kyle. Looks to dink one in. It's out for a goal kick. Rashford. Well played, he saw that coming. And here's Kane. Gets good distance on it. Great run on the overlap here. Nice touch. Foden provides an outlet. Just deflected over the goal line for a corner. No messing about, just bludgeoned away. Sir Harvey. And they win it back again.
England really are enduring a frustrating... Maddison!
Just a whisker away.
Gets it back. Tries to get it forward quickly. So, Jim, what are you thinking?
Well, while the temptation's always there, Peter, I think it would be ill-advised of them to try settle for what they've got.
Oh, well defended, that had to be done.
Israel are definitely going about this the right way.
Hitting hope is just about the sum of it, isn't it, Jim?
Spot on, Peter.
Foden, whose goal-scoring skills have already been evident, cuts it out, and it's played forward. And they've been caught out here.
Keep calm and carry on. That's the job in a nutshell now.
Now it's Kane.
This is good ball retention, and it should be enough from here, but they want to double their advantage.
Beautifully done. Maddison battles to win it back.
Israel are definitely not going down without a scrap. Their attitude just can't be faulted. Yeah, it's pretty obvious as to who was going to be taken off. His energy levels began to sag, and he was never going to last until the final whistle.
Played into the middle. Plenty waiting in the middle. Maddison
has a hit!
Knocks it away.
England are clearly looking to kill this game off. It's keeping the ball away from the other end, too.
Stones.
Well, we don't need to guess that they expect plenty of ball into the box.
It's quite a crowd scene in the middle now.
Well, it's a situation that requires resilience now and plenty of fighting spirit. It has to be matched.
And here's Sahavi. He's gone for it!
Attempt, the wrong outcome.
Oh, it's a very good effort. There wasn't much wrong with that at all. We're talking fine margins now.
England need to hold on for a few more moments. And it's played forward. Tries to get it forward quickly. Questions were asked. And he's given the answers. Kyle plays it out to the flank. That is it. The referee has seen enough. England needed by the only goal. Result, no question, the most important thing, however it came. Final score, 1-0. Back to winning ways. Two wins out of three. It is a very decent return.